When Alvin Bragg took over as the district attorney for Manhattan last year, actually about a year ago, it was reported later on that that Manhattan DA's office under Cy Vance, who left as was replaced by Bragg, they were days away, literally days away, is what the report said, from filing criminal charges against Donald Trump. Bragg came in, killed it, basically squashed the entire investigation, but didn't officially close it, to the point where the two lead prosecutors quit. They said, this is ridiculous. We've done all this work. We've put it all together. We have this ready to go. And Bragg basically kills it, but doesn't close it. And that's the important thing to remember. Well, things have changed. And Alvin Bragg in the last few weeks has really changed his tune recently, actually this week, telling the press that the investigation was on to the next chapter. So what is that next chapter? Well, we don't know exactly what it is, but we know who is involved in it. And that man happens to be Donald Trump's former lawyer slash fixer, Michael Cohen. Because Michael Cohen sat with those prosecutors for 2.5 hours this week. And although he is legally forbidden from telling us what they talked about, he was able to say that, yep, he talked to him. He feels good. He likes the direction things are going. And Michael Cohen, as we all know, is definitely not a guy who likes Trump anymore and would probably love to see him behind bars. So if Cohen comes out and says, hey, thumbs up, guys, I'm going to take that as a really great sign. But here's another thing, and this is likely what Cohen was talking about, and this is what the media is speculating. Bragg's office a couple months ago decided to take a second look, a deeper look, into the hush money payment to Stormy Daniels. Right? That's what Michael Cohen went to prison for Donald Trump. So if they're looking at that again, they could be looking at potential violations of New York campaign finance law. They could be looking at, because we know they actually wrote it off on their taxes. They wrote the damn hush money payment off on their taxes. So they could be looking at the tax angle on that too. I'm sorry, that's just hilarious. Like, corrupt all day long. And then like, hey, make sure you write the corruption up off on the taxes. I don't want to have to pay for that. Anything to save a buck, right? But there's a couple other things that have also happened recently that could be lighting the fire under Alvin Bragg's behind. One of those things, the big one, of course, is that the Trump Organization was found guilty. Alan Weisselberg was found guilty. They have been hit with massive fines. You still have that civil lawsuit pending against Donald Trump and Eric and Don Jr. and Ivanka. But so far, the state of New York against the Trump Organization and Trump family is winning. And maybe that has kind of relieved some of the fears that Alan Bragg has. And maybe he's looking at those verdicts and saying, okay, you know what? Maybe we can do this. Maybe I don't have to be such a pansy about it. But I tell you what I think the big thing is. I think this is the real reason that Bragg has changed his tune. And it's because Mark Pomerantz, who was one of the prosecutors I mentioned earlier that quit last year because Bragg killed the investigation, has a book about to come out. The book is going to be called People vs. Trump, An Inside Account. And Wednesday, Bragg's office sent a letter to Mark Pomerantz saying, whoa, you can't release all this. You can't put this information out because it could impede an ongoing criminal investigation. Which is good to know because, one, that does tell us that, hey, the criminal investigation is still ongoing. But to me, it shows something more than that. It tells me that Alvin Bragg knows, oh shit, this man is about to tell everything that we have, everything that we know, and then we didn't do anything about it, and we're going to get in trouble for that. So knowing this was coming out, that could be the biggest spark of the flame that apparently has been lit underneath Alvin Bragg. Honestly, I don't care which thing sparked him to re-energize this investigation. I'm just glad that it appears things are finally once again moving in the right direction, possibly directly towards Donald Trump. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified
every time a new video goes up.